guys. Some of you have been asking about the backgrounds I use for my daily dog portraits, so today we are going to do some printing. So I don't know about you guys, but I really don't like to paint on a white background. Something about starting with a color, almost any mid-tone value, just makes more sense to me. I think it makes it easier to judge all your values, both the darks and the lights, when you can see it up against a tone. And so whether it's toned paper or a ground placed on a canvas, starting from something like that always feels a little bit better than starting from a blank slate. So where did I get the idea for printing? Well, I think it came from a class that I took on abstract collage. I really loved the texture and interest that it created, but I didn't love all of the layers of paper and the mess that came along with it. So I wanted to create that same effect, but without all of that mess. And after trying a few different transfer methods, I found the gel plate, and I think it's just perfect for a couple of reasons. One is it's inexpensive. I think you can even create your own if you really want to. I can use the same acrylic paint that I already have, and it's relatively fast and easy once you get the hang of it. So here's how I do it. I start with the black paint, and with a brayer, I just apply a thin layer of it. And then I take my magazine or whatever I'm using as a transfer, photocopy, book, whatever it happens to be, and I apply it to the plate. Now, you don't want to leave this on for too long or press too much, or you'll lose all the details. But once that's up, I can take a look and see if the image is something that I like. If not, I can repeat the process or use a baby wipe to just eliminate some things. Once that layer is dry, it's time for the color. I like to use one or two colors at most, otherwise it can get a little muddy. And so I apply it with a brayer just like before, and then I'll quickly lay down the paper onto the plate. And I like to burnish it a little just to make sure that it's making good contact with the plate. Then I let it sit. If I'm patient, I let it sit for a few minutes before trying to pull up a corner and see if everything is ready. Once it's done, I just remove the paper and lay it flat to dry. Usually make at least 10 of these at a time. It's actually kind of addictive once you get started. I don't plan ahead what portrait I'm going to put on each one, but that's kind of the best thing. Since this is on paper and it's acrylic, you now have this beautiful smooth surface that you can paint on with more acrylic paint or draw on with colored pencils or inks or even oil paint if you want. It'll all work perfectly. I hope this was helpful for you, and I wonder if this is something that you've tried or something that you might want to try in the future. Let me know in the comments. And if there's anything else you'd like to see from my channel, just let me know. For now, don't forget to like and subscribe, and yeah, I'll see you soon.